ॐ साम्ये वसतु जिह्वायां वीणा पुस्तकधारिणी मुरारी वल्लभादेवी सर्वशुक्ला सरस्वती। हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधो जगतपते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते। श्रीमत् परम ब्रह्म गुरुं स्मरामि, श्रीमत् परम ब्रह्म गुरुं वदामि, श्रीमत् परम ब्रह्म गुरुं भजामि, श्रीमत् परम ब्रह्म गुरुं नमामि। आई बाउ टू माय बिलव्ड गुरुदेव, आई बाउ टू ऑल द मास्टर्स ऑफ द लिनिएज, आई बाउ टू ऑल द मास्टर्स of all times and all places, and behind me there is picture of a great master, said Sandipani, who was the guru of Lord Krishna and Lord Balarama. I bow to all the divine incarnations, Sri Krishna, Sri Rama, Jesus, Moses, Muhammad, Buddha, all. I bow to one God, all pervading, and I bow to all of you. Good evening. If I remember vaguely, I spent one night in New Jersey in between program. So this is for the first time to come to New Jersey and to have a program like this. Although I have been traveling and touring in USA since 1996. So I'm happy to be here in New Jersey, and it is said the garden state. I asked why New Jersey is a garden state. So they told there is lots of agricultural land, green, and so on. So happy to be in this garden state. And remember, this earth is the garden of God. And we all are the flowering and fruit-bearing plants. So we all are children of God on this planet Earth. I give my love and best wishes to all of you. This evening's talk is, what is the theme? Simple steps for inner peace. The body needs comfort. Mind needs happiness. And life needs peace. We need comfortable environment. The body needs comfort. When I came here and I sat down on this, you know, nice, comfortable seat, sometimes comfortable seat can be discomfort to somebody. And discomfortable seat can be comfortable to somebody. And that is what is our life is. Life needs the integration of comfort. As I told you, body needs comfort and mind needs happiness and life needs peace. To make this body comfortable, to make mind happy, and to make life peaceful, if we integrate these three, it is the art of cultivating inner peace. Most of the time people thought one will experience peace when one is in a peaceful environment. Yes, environment has its impact, but inner peace when we speak of, it is completely related with personal life and lifestyle, attitude and our activities. How do we live? How do we look at the world? How is our relationship? All this taken together. So while coming in the car, I was talking what to talk. And by God's grace, Guru's grace, most of the time I sit down and whatever God tells, I talk. It is not, I have a point what to talk. I have pre-planned, it is not truly. So However, everybody, when gets up from bed and expects everyone that it should be a good morning. When it will be a good morning, you just think how the morning will be good. Simple thing. We are living in modern world, in the most busy and active, dynamic country, and in the city like New York or New Jersey, or our life is quite, you know, hectic and busy. So if we want to begin our morning, the morning should be good morning. It is not with the words good morning, good evening. It should come from the inner feeling, this is a beautiful good morning. How? First thing, you should sleep well. And you should sleep not on the bed. You should sleep on the lap of God. I will tell you how. You are not sleeping on the bed, you are sleeping on the lap of God. This concept of sleeping on the lap of God came to me when I was young, living in my Guru's ashram. It was actually my Gurudev's ashram in Kodar ashram in Puri. The room where I was sleeping was adjacent to my master's room. And his bed was touching the wall, and my sleeping place was also touching the same. So the difference, distance between he and me, or the, you can tell, barrier was like the wall. I was quite young. When I was lying down on the bed, I was thinking, I'm sleeping next to my Gurudev. Just like we sleep on the same bed, maybe you have your blanket, I have my blanket. There is a little distance. And that is like this, we are sleeping on the same bed. And slowly when I grew up, and grew up inwardly, I practiced living in the presence of God. I found God is omnipresent. God is everywhere. When God is everywhere, isn't God on the bed? And this practice also I did. If I am covering my body, it is not a quilt or a sheet. It is also hand of God. So God is putting his hand on me. I am sleeping on his lap with him, just like a mother is holding the baby and baby is sleeping. And if we have a good sleep, naturally we'll. And when we go to sleep, we go with the hope that we'll get up. Be very good. It is not a pessimistic statement. Is there any guarantee we'll get up? Many people, recently, last April, a disciple, a doctor, a radiologist, he slept, his wife slept on the same bed, and the wife found that he's no more, gone. So there is no guarantee, but we live with hope. If anybody will have a doubt, I will get up or not, cannot sleep until and unless he or she is a yogi and dedicated to God. If one has fear that if I sleep, I will not get up. Can he sleep? No. So we are sleeping on the lap of God and with a hope. So what is this hope? That I am alive and I will be alive. And remember, it is truth behind. I am alive, I will be alive, even if this body will not be there. One day, today or tomorrow, who knows? Tomorrow means not, I am telling, 1st June 2019. So, body will not remain tomorrow, but I will remain. So, have a good morning. Good morning, you get up, not with the call of the alarm clock. Nowadays, people are not using alarm clock, you know. They are using alarming telephone. So, this telephone is, you know, in my young age, we had two in one. Radio and tape recorder together, they called two in one. So now it is, I don't know if they have given a name, everything in one. So this mobile telephone. However, I will get up early in the morning, not with the call of the alarm clock or the alarming telephone, I will get up joyfully. I will not get up in hurry. I will get up in the proper time so that I will not be in hurry to rush. I'm getting delayed. No. Go to bed early. Get up early. When you get up, don't jump from your bed and go. Because you have got up early. Just sit down in a relaxed mood. Look at yourself. If there is a picture of, for example, any aspect of divinity, Lord Krishna, or Lord Rama, or Jesus, or whomever, just look at them. Thank you. I am grateful. This practice I learned from my Gurudev. He used to tell that when my sleep is gone, still I am lying down on the bed, I move my body and I feel, still now, not only I am alive, this body is not paralyzed, it is active. Because I am now 80 plus, I am 90 plus. My Gurudev left his body at the age of 95 years, 6 months, 6 days. At this age also, he has kept this body active. With a little smile, it is gratitude. Oh God, I am so much grateful to you. Life which we have, this human life, it is really a gift. Yes, we have some burden, we have some responsibilities, we have difficulties, we have challenges, we have problems. Yes, we have. There is no life without problem. If you, for example, if Lord Krishna, we are sitting in the temple of Lord Krishna, if Lord Krishna will sit down and sit in front of you just like I am sitting in your front, and we'll have nice chat with him, and we'll tell, Lord Krishna, do you know, I have so much a problem. He would say, have you not seen how much problem I did have? I was born in the prison. I was taken away from the prison secretly. And I grew up in a, they are not my parents, but I grew up with so much of troubles. Remember, life is a challenge. Life is a battle. Life is a struggle. We have to grow through it. Very little example. We are in the garden state. Have you done gardening? If you have done gardening, have you planted any seed in the soil? If you have planted seed in the soil, not the sapling, you put little water or sprinkle little water, that sprout is slowly swelling up and slowly it is trying to raise its head from the soil, and the plant is growing in two ways. The root is growing downward and the seed slowly coming out and with, you know, against gravity, lifting up this load of soil up from its head and coming out a little sprout. Have you seen it? And how it is growing? A little seed has so much of strength to overcome the load on its head and coming out, growing up against gravity, growing towards light. We all have problems. But to begin the morning with a smile, suppose in the morning you get up in hurry. There is, and you are with the family, if there is no smile towards each other, if you do not greet each other, hello, good morning, with a smile, and taking the name of God, begin the morning in love, in joy, in peace. That is the first step. Start the day in peace. Start the day in love. Start the day in joy. Begin the day with God, with masters, with smile, with promise, because it is a new beginning, new day. God has given this new day. How I am going to move? If begin the day a good morning, then what the next step? We are living in the modern world. You will tell, I don't have time. Find a little time to sit down quietly the peace and happiness that you experienced during your sleep, feel it in your simple prayer room or meditation room or where you have little altar, even on your bed if you don't have space, spend few minutes quietly, reflect upon. Do you know, my Gurudev used to say, hurry, worry, hurry and worry, this steals our merry, you know, joyful state. So, why should I be in a hurry? Why I should be worried? How to resolve it? I'll tell you the example from the life of a great son of India. He was a businessman. I'm not telling his name. And he was very successful, and he was a great supporter of Gandhi, and he was financing Gandhi for freedom struggle. You know, you need some fund, and Gandhi was financed by quite a few, he was one. And as he was a very successful businessman, he had partnership with God. God is my partner. He had a room. In the room, two chairs. One chair for him, one chair for God. Oh God, this challenge has come. You are my partner. And you are my, you know, not 50-50. You are the major partner, shareholder. So what to do? Sitting quietly, praying to God, whatever inspiration he felt. And he took that step. And he spent a lot during those days in charity, as I told you, helping Gandhi and so on. If you want to hear his name was Ghanshyam Das Birla. G.D. Birla, Birla family, you know. Begin the morning, little bit interaction, relationship. You know, if I have a friend and friend is very helping, friend is rich, friend is motivating, friend is, you know, and I need not have to worry, he is there. If I have any need, he is there. Even if I don't call him, he is there. And in our life, and we have. So begin the morning with this much. Now, as I told you, this body, mind, and life, to keep this body comfortable, how to make this body comfortable? I think if now Swami Vivekananda will come and appear, Paramahamsa Yogananda would come and appear, they will be happy to see all of you. Do you know what? When they came, people did not know how to sit on the floor. The American people. They did not know how to sit on the floor. And they will be sitting there. People from America sitting on the floor, crossed leg, and even if you tell they can sit with lotus posture sitting, they will be really happy. So, the purpose of telling this, to keep this body in comfort and ease means no disease. You know, the word disease is coming from the original word EASE. Disease is disease. So what is ease? From ease comes easy, ease, comfort, without any. So to make your body free from disease, you should have one easy life. Easy life means this body should be little flexible, body should be healthy, body should be, we don't know tomorrow what will happen. Thakur Ramakrishna can have cancer, Ramana Maharshi can have physical ailment, Sri Lahiri Mahasaya, there is no guarantee. Where there is body, there will be something this and that. So, to keep this body healthy every day if it is possible, do little exercises every day, no compromise. So, every day little exercises, every day little, at least go for a little walk, or if you have garden, spend little time in garden. bend your body, dig soil, put this, or combine these three. It really keeps you working in the garden. It's very nice. The thought of garden came because when I, you know, I have a monkey mind. My mind works in a many direction. When I'm sitting on the car, my eyes go to the front car, my eyes go to the side car, my eyes go to the left car, my eyes go to the billboards. Today I read, what was in the billboard? If you want to meet God after your death, so call. Then I read, eat healthy, bro. I asked, what is bro? Then I was told, it is brother. Eat healthy, brother. So my mind goes here and there. So today I have seen garden state so much. So this world is a garden. Life is a garden. Those who know gardening, what they do, they dig the soil, take the weeds away, make the soil little, you know, leveled. They take the seed and plant it, then they sprinkle water, then if there is need for some manure, they put it, the plant is growing up, they see that no pests or insects are eating, and it should grow. And now it is springtime, and it will grow here in countries like here or in the like New Jersey, in summertime they grow very quick. And they don't grow so quick in India. Here they grow very quick. So, however, life is a garden. Just like you do gardening, you have to weed out. What to weed out? From this body, laziness. You have to weed out laziness. Because when you get up, you can see the children when they are sleeping. In the morning, when you tell that you get up and to get ready to go to school, the child is not willing to go to school. So, little inertia is there, because when sleep, the body becomes little lazy. So, if we want really peace, make your body active. Let not your body be lazy. Little exercises every day. Little good food every day. This is for comfort. Now, if you want peace, then you move forward. Now the whole day, what shall I do the whole day? I have my job, I have my business, I have my family, I'm telling of myself, I have my job, I have my business, I have also my family. You'll tell what, Swami, you have a job? Yes, I have a job. And you have a job, suppose 5 days a week, 8 hours every day, and God has given you freedom, you may not go to your office, you can work from your home. I have a job, 24 hours, 7 days. You have job, I have job. My job, somebody was asking, how could you manage, this evening somebody was asking, how do you manage traveling so much? I said, what to do? I have no alternative. If I would have some better job, I would have chosen. This is the best job and the only job I have available. So, throughout the year, no weekend, no vacation, no, I have my job. You will tell, okay, Swamiji, you understand. You have a job means you are talking of, you have business. Yes, I have business. So, what type of business you have? If you ask me, in two ways I will tell. If you ask financially, I will tell I have business. What type of business? If you look at my travel document, somewhere it is written, author, publisher. Okay? I am an author, I am a publisher. So, I write books, I promote books. So, you buy a book, I get some money. So, it is business. Forget about this business. We all are businessmen. So, our investment or our asset is our time. Our investment, our asset is our time. Each of us, we are investing our time. Suppose you are investing time in your work. Out of 24 hours, few hours. How much time you are investing, in which way you will get the result? The time. Second investment we all have talent. We all have talent. We all are talented. Even the little children are so talented. Oh God, they can, which, you know, I know something, but I am full in many ways. I don't know how to operate this mobile telephone. Nowadays, you do, they're rubbing the finger, it is working, and the children know more than their parents. How to use this, how to, they know it. We have talent. We have time. We have talent. We have to utilize it. Any job you have, Swamiji, I don't like my job. Very stressful. Swamiji, my family is this. This is happening, that is happening. I have job, I have business, I have the family. My family is, you all are. You have a small family with few kids. I have a big family. Do you know what happens? Sometimes people ask me, how was your sleep? If I tell truth, you will tell, oh God, I don't like this job. Most of the time I say, after 1.5 hours, I don't have sleep. I lie down. Then I analyze why, what is the cause? Why my sleep is disturbed? I have nothing to worry so much, but mostly I don't sleep. I sleep a little, I lie down, dream a little, this. It is because of people. What people? People in trouble. They tell, Baba, help me, I'm going to hospital without telephone. So, in a subtle way, so it is my duty to pray. That is my job. So, I have to pray. So, however, accept. If you want to be happy in your life, peaceful, accept. What to accept? I have a friend, very loving friend. We loved each other and we got initiated. So, together, that friend was little bit concerned about his height. He was maybe little taller than me. I was never unhappy I'm thankful to God that God made me small. Do you know why? Because of the aeroplanes. So, you sit in the economy class, you sit like this. I sit like this. In the aeroplane also, I sit like this. So, comfortable, no problem. If I would have been a little bigger, so, and sometimes I have a little bit trouble, but it's also okay. I am in the middle seat, two people, and they are little, you know, like this. And they encroach my side. I sit like this. Then I think, oh God, it is a nice opportunity to be sandwiched for a while. And it has happened many times. However, that friend of mine did not like that he is small in height. So, unfortunately, he saw some ad, how to be taller. And there is a book. And he ordered that book. Usually he tells me what he does. I came to know about him that he has ordered a book. I said, do you know what is in the book? You have ordered this book? He said, yes. You will get a book. And during those days, I am telling it is about 36, 37 years ago. So, you will get a small, thin booklet. And during those days, 100 rupees. It was a lot of money. 37 years ago. You will find a small, thin booklet nicely packed in a big box. And when you open it, it will be written, use high heel shoes. Don't put oil on your hair, shampoo it and comb your hair like this. He said, no. And the book came. It was a thin booklet, which will be not even 1 rupee. He has paid 100 rupees. And whatever I told, it was written there. He came to me with a gloomy face and telling, do you know this thing happened? I said, why you did not ask me? I could have told you how to be taller without paying 100 rupees. He was not happy with what he was. Accept what you are. God has given this body. Accept it. Do you know, when I was a little child, I was a sick, weak, skeletal. If you would have taken my photo during those days, you could have said that this boy is from Africa with no food. You can count my ribs. Everything visible. Accept it. In life, we forget to accept. accept, suppose this job I have, accept it. If you have alternative, change it. So long as alternative is not there, this job is giving you opportunity to survive. Thankfully, this job I have. Many people have no jobs. Smile. Accept it. This is my wife. This is my children. God has given. Nowadays, we might have challenging family situations. Accept with courage. God has given. Don't accept failure. Accept what is there, but never accept failure. Accept failure if wife and husband has little, you know, want to accept failure is very fine. Sometimes, you know, I will not accept failure if I am quarreling with my wife, it is not good. So, don't accept failure in life. If you don't accept failure, there is hope to succeed. Once you accept failure means full stop. So, live your everyday, whatever your work or job or business, with love, in goodness, in thanksgiving, in peace. Remember, peace is not something which will come from heaven. Peace is to be cultivated, peace is to be earned. Health is to be cultivated, health is to be earned. Comfort is to be cultivated, not that, okay, this is the sit, I am to sit now for 1 hour 30 minutes, I will accept it. This will be comfortable. If I don't accept it, there is opportunity, I will go sit down and sit down on the floor. That's fine. So, in life, if you accept, many problems will be resolved. This is my family, I accept. These are my parents, I accept. These are my brothers and sisters, I accept, they are my own. Acceptance is a, you know, is a virtue, and it gives strength and courage, and it helps you not to react. Now, you spend the time, now you come back in the evening. When you come back in the evening, what to do? You come back with stress, come back with unhappiness, come back with worry, come back with unhappiness, come back with something happened in your job. Do you know? The modern time is very good. It has given lots of opportunities, but it is a troublemaking time. You will tell, what is the troublemaking time? Troublemaking time, you just think. 30 years ago, 40 years ago, you are, suppose somebody is going to work, went to work and came back, finished. Nothing with the office, no connection, nothing. Now, computer came, mobile telephone came, you are trapped. You are trapped. So, what is the trap? The trap is you can be trapped at any time, anywhere, where you are. So, nowadays, where you are driving, I didn't know this. In Delhi, I came to know from a disciple because his driver took me. I asked the disciple, how could you know that he is here? He said, because of the GPS. The owner at home can detect where his driver is. It's very, however, this computer gave lots of opportunities, and computer brings you, when you come back home, it is my time for the family. What is happening in our life? We give time to everybody. We don't have time for ourselves. We don't have time for our family. I'll tell you one, in my experience as a wandering teacher, I meet people, I see problem, I, by God's grace, somewhere some solution comes out. I was brand new in West. I didn't know so much of Western lifestyle practices and this. So, it was in 1994, October, I was in Holland. In Holland, in Gurudev's ashram. So, after noon meditation, I was sitting in the garden. One young man came and sat next to me. Can I ask, talk to you? I said, yes. He said, I'm meditating, but my family life is miserable. I said, why? What is the cause? He said, my family's wife is very non-cooperative. When I sit to meditate, bangs the door, switches on the television very loud. I have a cute, sweet daughter and tells the daughter to jump on me when I'm sitting to meditate. And he went on telling everything against the wife. You cannot tell everything against the wife. That must be something good or something wrong in you. So I'll tell you a story. The story is two friends met each other. It's a story. But the other one, I'll continue the real incident. So the two friends met each other and they were friends from young age and they have got married. They are living at different places. So when they met each other, they said, one is asking, how is everything? How is your family? And miserable. And he went on complaining about the wife. He said, you know, you are complaining. Have you ever appreciated your wife? He said, what to appreciate? She has nothing to be appreciated. He said, don't say this. If you really want peace, happiness, do one thing. First thing, you appreciate her food. Today, when you go and have dinner, you tell that the food is very nice. Okay, I'll do it. Once you appreciate, situation will change. Because you accept. When you appreciate, you accept something. So, he told, I'm really happy that today food is very nice. She said, enough. Every day I cook, never you appreciate it. Today I was feeling sick. I brought some food from the restaurant and you are appreciating food for the restaurant. So now come back to this young man. I told, you go back. I asked, what is your timetable? He said, I got up at early in the morning. I sit down and try to meditate. Then I get ready because there's time to go for work. And I go to work and come back. I sit for some time for meditation. I thought, oh God, this man is meditating or creating trouble in the family, that because surely the wife will think, what meditation? There is no time to sit together, to talk together. I told, do one thing. After listening to his timetable, when you go back from this program, first you smile. Tell your wife thank you. And take her in the evening to market to do shopping. Play with your daughter. Find your time when others are sleeping or this. Meditate a little. You can compromise a little, but do this. Do you know what happened? January first week. No, it was October. December. December first week, we were in Germany. And I saw that young man is sitting. I said, hello, how are you? He said, I'm fine. My wife has come. I said, for what? For initiation. It was the end of October, Middle East, November. In 1 month, there was change in the behavior of. Why I'm telling, we have to accept, we have to appreciate. And then when we come back home or find everyday time to spend together. Spend together, cook together, take food together, sit together, talk together. Unfortunately, modern times, people are becoming like this. Do you know why? This morning, I was in my host's place. The wife is calling the husband to get up. Do you know how? Mobile telephone. If you are to call, go to him, touch him, tell get up. They are elderly people. So, spend time, sit together, talk together, take food together. There will be more understanding. If you want peace in life, inner peace, there should be understanding. Without understanding, there will be no inner peace. Evening time, spend a little bit time, not too long, maybe few minutes, sit quietly. 5 minutes, 10 minutes, sit quietly. Think of the whole day, what has happened, pray to God, be grateful, take food, go to your bed. Start the day with God, in peace, in love, in joy. Spend the day in God, in peace, in love and joy. Evening, end the day with God, in peace, love and joy. Your life is in peace. Apart from this, few tips I will tell you what we all should practice. The first is, take care of your desires. Take care of your desires. I got a book. The book is, what is the book? Heaven. I got a book, its name is Heaven. And the same author, the book is Earth. So in the Heaven, it is written that after a long walk, I reached the entrance of Heaven and I knocked the door and I was asked, have you come to see God? The answer was, no, I have come to stay here. The door opened, I moved forward, the inner door was closed, then I was asked, what have you brought with you, yourself? He said, the answer was, I have brought nothing, I have come myself. The door was opened. The third door, the voice came, why you have come here, what do you need? He said, I have come here to stay, but I need to love, to understand and to do. In our life, then he's telling, I went further, there are customs office, because you know, just like you come to USA, immigration customs, so you come. So in the customs, there is a declaration form to declare. So there is a list. Are you carrying this with you? So it is written there. It is a very interesting book, old but interesting book. Body is there. Body has some need. Life is there. Life has some need. Family is there, family has some need. Am I clear? It needs, body needs food, body needs clothes. Suppose I have come here, tomorrow morning I have to fly to from New Jersey to Chicago. So I need a ticket. So out of many things I don't know, one thing I don't know how to drive. So I need John Baba to come and to take me to the airport. Thank God I don't know driving. Do you know why? If I would have known driving, so I would not have such expensive drivers near me. All are expensive drivers. So if I would have been knowing how to drive, I would have been using only one type of car. I have many types of cars. So many drivers, many types of cars. So however, there is need. But unfortunately, we multiply our desires and then we have greed, and if we have greed and desire, we cannot be in peace. I will tell you a story of disease 99. The story of disease 99. You will tell, what is this disease 99? Once upon a time, there was a rich man, near the rich man's big house, there was a small hut, or a poor man was living, and the wife told the rich man at one late hours of night when they were going to retire after seeing everything is all right. The wife of the rich man told, you know, our neighbor who is poor, but they are in peace and happiness which we don't have. Look, it is now already after midnight, we are going to bed. And we are going to bed, if there is anything, I knew one businessman, very successful and rich businessman. After Christmas evening meditation, went to her place. It was in West. And I got a telephone call from her. Baba, I got the alarm, burglar alarm. Somebody has tried to enter her factory. She has jewelry factory. So I am going there. Please pray for me. So, however, this rich man's wife, when was narrating how they are happy, peaceful, he said, he didn't say anything. What he did, he told, I'm coming. Went to his vault and took gold coins, 99. put in a container and very silently dropped it into this small, you know, house. Early morning, the poor man's wife, while she was brooming, she found a and called her husband. Both of them sat down and opened it, gold coins. Started counting, 99. He became unhappy. Again counted, 99. Again counted, 99. If it would have been 100. And to have one gold coin, he had to work hard, spend less. Wife is unhappy that you are not bringing enough food, enough this. Wait, I want to make one gold coin. Happiness disappeared. And one day, the wife is, rich man's wife is telling the her husband, what is happening to this family? They are so happy, peaceful, and now it is gone. He said, it is disease 99. What is disease 99? Then he narrated. And many of us have been victim of this disease. Our need is less, our greed is more, and desire. As a student of economics, and those who have studied economics, they know in the beginning of economics, we tell human wants are unlimited. The first one, human wants are unlimited. This is the foundation of economics. Resources are limited. Wants are unlimited. With you cannot satisfy unlimited wants with limited resources. Very simple thing, it is taught in economics, but how we live? Unlimited wants, we want to fulfill unlimited wants, and which is impossible. So what happens? Make your need little regulated. It is enough to have few pairs of clothes. Here when I come to different families, suppose if I go to your home, you'll, so sometimes I open their closet and they have kept two, three, they say you can keep your clothes there and two, three hangers for me to put my shirt, and I see how much is it really needed. However, desires, if you want have peace in life, take care of your desire, take care of your need, put a little ceiling, this is enough. If you want, this is one, if you want to be happy and peaceful, the technique I am telling, take care of your breath. Take care of your breath. You will tell, what is this? Restless breath, restless mind. Peaceful breath, peaceful mind. Take care of your breath. Practice little pranayama if you can. In Kriya Yoga, what we do, the more emphasis on breath, watch your breath, love your breath, in every breath, remember God, remember Krishna, remember Jesus, remember Rama. So take care of your breath. Now, last thing I will tell, keep smiling. Swamiji, troubles are there. How can I smile? Do you know, once trouble came to a person. Normally, when trouble comes, they come with their friends and relatives. So when the trouble came, one person smiled. The trouble got terrified. Why this man is smiling? Wherever I go, they get worried, they got depressed, they got distressed, they got, you know, tense, they get tension, they got anxiety, they got fear. But this man is smiling. The trouble, is this man going to a monk or going to meditation classes or going to temple? Surely this monk is following somebody, otherwise seeing me, people get scared and he's smiling. The trouble disappeared. Do you know, if you smile, you will get so much of strength within. Keep smiling. Smile increases your face value. Smile, you know, when you smile, when you smile, the cheeks come up. Scientists are telling, one who is smiling, his body immunity increases. Smile increases body immunity. Smile heals people. Smile makes a person stronger. It is said that the smile, with smile, few muscles are used. When you frown, more muscles are used. So somebody sent me this scientific, you know, information. In smile, how many muscles? in frowning how many muscles, I don't remember exactly. So I wrote back, it is better to frown because it will have muscular exercises. It was a joke. Keep smiling. If you really smile in a smiling environment, in a joyful environment, we can experience more peace. Paramahamsa Yogananda said, wherever you go, carry a portable heaven with you. Wherever you go, carry a portable heaven with you. Wherever we are going, carrying a portable computer, iPad, and this modern iPhone, and this we are carrying, he is telling portable heaven. What does it mean? Heavenly joy, heavenly peace, smile, love, happiness. We'll meditate for a few minutes and then we'll conclude this program. Wherever you are sitting, sit little straight. Keep your eyes closed. We are in this temple, but our body is the real temple. In the temple, the deities are there. Inside this body temple, the soul is there. The soul entered the body temple through the soft place on the top of the head called as fontanelle. A baby's soft place on the head. Because of this soul, breath is going in and coming out. When the soul will leave body, no breath, death. We should love our breath. Inhalation and exhalation. Just watch it. Inhale, feel the movement of air through the nostril. Exhale, feel the movement of air through the nostril. Inhale, thank God, O God. Exhale, with love and thanks. Inhale, in love, and exhale, in peace. Sarve bhavantu sukhinah, sarve santu niramayah, sarve bhadrani pasyantu, ma kaschit dukkha bhag bhavet. Om purnamadah, purnamidam, purunat purnamudachyate, purnasya purnamadaya, purnameva avashishyate. Om shantihi, shantihi, shantihi. I bow to God. Bow to my beloved Gurudev, and I bow to all of you. Thank you all.